Namaste, welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make puris for Panipuri. A very foolproof recipe that you won't go wrong if you follow the tips and the recipe properly. So let's begin. So let's look at the ingredients. Only three ingredients needed to prepare the dough. All you need is 1/2 cup of rava, also known as semolina or soji, 1/2 cup of whole wheat flour, and water. Into the mixing bowl, take rava, whole wheat flour, mix really well. Next, add water as you go, little at a time, and prepare the dough, not too hard, not too soft, kind of a bakri dough. So you can see that it has already formed into the dough. Perfect. So this is how the dough should be. You can see that it is not too hard and not too soft. So it took about 1/4 cup of water form into nice ball, and cover with damp towel and allow it to rest for about 30 minutes. All right, the dough has been resting for about 25 minutes and I'm going to roll and fry the puris now. So let's check, knead it one more time and make about lemon size of balls. And while you are working, make sure to keep it covered. So here I have my rolling pin and dry flour. I'm using rice flour, you can just use plain flour. So dust a little bit of a dry flour. And press the ball as much as you can from the sides to seal all the cracks, and then roll. Don't roll too thin, keep it a little bit thicker because you want puffed puris as much as you can. Some won't puff up, but that's fine, you just want to try your best that most puris puff up. And in order to do that, roll a little bit thicker, not too thick though. Perfect, like so. And then using something round, you can just use about anything, just make sure that the diameter is not too big and that you can easily cut the puris. Then just remove the extra part, and so you will have all the puris left like so. Heat up the oil on a medium to high heat. When the oil is hot, start frying the puris. Don't worry if not all puris puff up. Wow, all of them puffed up nice. Now make sure to fry properly until you see light golden brown color. Otherwise, they will be soft. You want them crunchy. They're hard to flip on the other side because they pop up like a pillow. But be sure to get brown color on both sides. When done, bring down onto the side to drain extra oil. and bring it down on to the paper towel. So most of my puris are puffing up nicely, as you can see. So here I have all the puffed puri, and so far these are the puris I have that did not puff up. All right, so I'm done frying all the puris. These are the puris that puffed nicely, which I can use to stuff in. So let me show you. Just poke lightly on the top to fill it in. Look at all these puris. Now you are ready to prepare Golgappas, also known as Puchka, also known as Panipuri. So just prepare the mint water. I have already shared the recipe of making puris and the pani for panipuris, and I found this recipe quite easier than the one that I shared earlier. So I thought I need to share this with you all, and believe me or not, in the very first attempt, you will be so satisfied with this recipe. And in this video, I thought of sharing how to make dahipuri. So here I have all the ingredients ready to prepare the dahipuri. Finely chopped tomato, onion, beaten yogurt. You can flavor with cumin and salt if desired. Sev, besan sev, and then boiled chana. I have a chickpea and the black chana, also known as Bengal gram, whole Bengal gram. Then I have all the chutneys, garlic, tamarind and coriander chutney, lasan, imli and dhania chutney. Then I have finely chopped coriander leaves, dhania and mint pudina. And time to prepare the dahi puri. So all you have to do is arrange the puris and make the hole in the puris to stuff in. And simply stuff one by one with the vegetables, boiled chana, even potato can be used, and then drizzle chutneys, sprinkle, besan sev, and that is it. How is it, Drew?
Good.
Good? And here I have some that did not puff. These puris can be used in a bel puri or chaat papri. Simply amazing. You can just, you can even munch on them. You can hear the crunch. Perfect crunchiness. I always keep all the chutneys and boiled chickpeas and sprouted moong and everything in my freezer, so whenever I crave for any Indian street food, especially chaats, I am just ready to prepare anytime, since I keep all the stuff almost ready. Store the prepared puris into the airtight container and it stays great up to a month. So I hope I made it easier for you to prepare puris for panipuris. Thank you for watching and see you soon.